So back to Manor Farm Leisure. There's two lakes in today, Middle Pool and Windmill. I've drawn Windmill Peg 17, which is one of the deepest legs, deepest pegs on the complex, not legs, pegs. It's about 9 foot and it shelves off about 11-ish metres. So probably not the best sort of pegs to draw this time of year with high pressure and stuff, but you know, might catch shallow, hoping to catch shallow, so I'm going to start short. I haven't fed anywhere else, just going to tap in some pellets and just fish a soft expander over the top. Definitely not the start I wanted. Just lost three, just pulled out. I don't know what happened. I even replumbed to make sure that my rig was fine, which it was. So just fishing on a slope. As you can see, I just lost a fish then. Obviously, this is speeded up. So just pinging my 13 meter line. I'm not sure why I lost some fish to start off with. So you know, lost three. Just replumbed up. Rig was fine.
I've hooked three and lost all three. At least I'm consistent.
So rig wise, just fishing a 0.4 gram John Walker float, 018 main line, 012 bottom, and just fishing the Naver hybrid elastic, the red stuff, which I believe is a 1.4 or maybe a 1.6. So nice and soft, so I'm not going to bump anything off. There's a lot of skimmers and lots of F1s that vary in different sizes if you don't know the venue. That is the nice thing about being there. When the float goes under, it could be anything from a 20 pound cart to a 4 ounce F1. I felt steady-ish on this line, but I felt, you know, it was never electric. But looking around the lake, then I'm playing 22, slipped to my right opposite. It's caught really well on record to begin with. And then Mike on 24 on Windmill.
It's
just caught really well catching stockies against the island.
Yeah, the original.
It turns out he won the lake. He won the match for fair play to him. And we need 26 pounds, I believe. All the weights were at the end.
What?
You see, like, the guy to my left, Mike, all the way down, he's playing the fish now, yeah. So just loose feed in, fours, and the odd pouch of 6 mil pellets. So just hinders course pellets, well, cart pellets, and the course pellets. And then short and just feeding some seafood and micro pellets. And again, some 4 and 6 mil, wetted down cart pellets. So the long line produced a lot better than I thought it was going to on the deck. So in literally an honest 9 foot of water, I didn't think this would be as good as what it was. However, obviously it was so long, it didn't last. It literally, after an hour and, I think it was an hour and 37 minutes or something, the peg just died. Completely, and it won't just die for me, it died for quite a lot of anglers. And then the sun got up, and it just, I don't know, just completely and utterly switched off. There's loads of fish there to begin with, so it wasn't like, you know, I'd done something wrong and everyone else carried on catching. They just decided to switch off, and we could catch them shallow. I tried monging, tapping, slapping. Fishing a nice light rig through the water and stuff, just could not get no bites. And when I say me catching F1 in the last 3.5 hours of the match, I do mean a lot longer than that. It was pretty much almost 4 hours. So a little bit disappointing. Gary Watts caught well on peg 4, he caught nugget. There's a few fish like moving around and stuff. I had odd fish cruising through, but nothing. You know, I tried to flip the rig at them, but they just shied away. There wasn't very many of them, and a few of the fish were charging through the peg, so they weren't really worth targeting.
on river monsters. Is it a river monster?
As you can see, the conditions are beginning to change. The sun's coming very bright, no ripple, just making it quite difficult to catch. And the lakes were, well, this lake was noticeably quite clear. Windmill, I would say, in my opinion, is probably the clearest lake out of all of them, maybe because it's the deepest. There might be another explanation why, I honestly don't know, but it is definitely the clearest lake out of all of them. And that, therefore, that can make it obviously the most difficultest lake at times to catch. So with this higher pressure, we've had loads of rain, you like to think the fish are going to come up in the water. So it sort of forced my hand really a little bit. I'm thinking that I've got to go shallow. And have any real signs of any swirls or lots of missed bites, which would indicate that there's lots of fish in the peg or fish moving up in the water. So, but I feel like I've got to do that.
Yeah, I've actually got an original fish.
So I don't know how many times I lifted, dropped and slapped and tapped and stuff, but it just did not happen. I'm trying to give it quite a bit of bait, which maybe isn't the right thing to do, I don't know. And then I did drop, which won't be seen in the video because the battery ran out. But I did drop short fish maggots and had quite a nice day, really. Caught a lot of roach, a few skimmers and stuff. I weighed 55 pounds to win the 4-peck section, so not doom and gloom, but still quite a tough day at the office. Just unbelievable how them fish just switched off after like an hour and 40 minutes. Hope you've enjoyed the video. I'll catch you soon.